Hi, welcome to this session on retail store layout. Today we are going to discuss the different aspects of laying out a store for retail purposes. First and foremost, why is the store layout so important? Studies have proved that the longer the customer stays within the store, the higher is the chance that they are going to pick up more products. So your average bill value or the basket value is likely to increase if your customer stays longer in the store. So a good store layout has a lot of importance because that is what determines how long a customer typically stays inside the store. The store layout also influences the shopping decisions. For example, if the placement of products is not correct, then the customer might not be able to find the correct product that they're looking for. Products which are specifically for kids, if they are not placed to the appropriate height within the shelves where kids can actually reach, then it is less likely that they are going to be picked up. The store layout also has a lot to do with how much is the returns from the space that is available for the retailer that the retailer is able to earn. Appropriate utilization of the space is also one of the major beneficial aspects of having a good store layout. Then the next most important factor for having a good store layout is obviously to give a good positive experience for the customer. And lastly, but not the least, every retail organization or every retail store has a particular positioning with respect to what they are trying to portray to the customers. For example, there are outlets which are premium, then there are outlets which are deep discount outlets, and the store interiors or the store layout should go in accordance with that overall positioning that the retailer has. If you are trying to be premium in your products, in the kind of customers you want to attract, then the store interiors or the layout and the ambience should also be commensurate with that. Moving on, what are the different elements of a retail store layout? The first is the planning and circulation. The second is the store front and the facade. The third is the store communication. The fourth is the category flow. The fifth, the store fixtures. Sixth is the materials, finishes, and the lightings and the music which are used within the store. We are going to take each of these elements and go into details. The first is the planning and circulation. Now, planning and circulation is very important because this is what helps people navigate within the store. Now, it is also important that the customers who are coming in are actually moving around and visiting all the different areas of the store. Now, there are going to be categories which are very, very highly likely to be picked up by customers. Say, for example, biscuits. For example, your chips, your savories, your confectioneries, chocolates. These are very, very impulsive items, and most likely every customer will definitely pick up at least one item from these categories. But then there are other categories which are slightly less popular or low penetration categories. It could be something like over-the-counter drugs. It can be something like your body lotions and other such categories where people, if they do not see, they might not remember that they need to pick it up. So in those kind of categories, you need to ensure that the customers definitely walk through those categories before reaching the high penetration categories. This only improves the propensity of the customers to pick up something and for the retailers to do some more sales. Plus, there are some of the outlets of retail stores which are multi-layered or multi-storied. In that case, it is also very important that people we have a proper flow through which the customers visit both the stairs or multiple of the stairs. And the customer should find it easy to navigate between the categories. That should be one of the most prime concerns while designing the planning and circulation. Lastly, but not the least, it should provide the customers with the flexibility to shop and should not be too rigid. What it means is that it should encourage the customers to visit all the areas of the store, but at the same time, it should not be so rigid, the navigation should not be so rigid that unless the customer visits all the areas of the store, they are not able to reach the categories that they really want to go to. And we need to understand the concept of the power aisle. The power aisle is the main aisle of the store, and that is the basically the spine of the store, and the entire store layout should be aligned with respect to the power aisle. Moving to the next important element, which is the store front or the facade. Now, store front or store facade does a very important job of communicating the positioning of that particular retail outlet. So if it is a premium outlet, it is more likely that the outer facade is going to be much more gaudy. It is likely to have a very good dressing window. Whereas if it is a deep discount kind of a retailer, it is mostly likely to be very plain, very mundane. Secondly, the storefront also gives a visibility into the interior of the store. So it is like a window within the through which the customer from outside can have a glimpse of what is there inside the store. So it is also very important that there is adequate visibility from the storefront into the store. There are the concept of store windows where you can showcase the kind of products that you have or certain specific collections that you want to highlight. That again also communicates the kind of positioning that the store or the retail outlet wants to portray. The materials that are used in the storefront also communicates with respect to the positioning of the store, whether it's an upmarket store or whether it's a deep discount store or whether it's just a convenience outlet. And overall, the storefront and the store interiors should be in sync. Moving to the next element, it is the store communication. Now, store communications are the communications which are there to guide the customers to certain categories or to certain product sets. They also guide the customers with respect to promotions and anything that the retailer wants to highlight specifically to these customers. Store communications help with navigations because they are pointers towards the categories. The shelf markers make it easy for the customers to identify the products. They provide information on the products, on the categories. They provide what are the product benefits, if there are any particular schemes going on. All that communication can happen. And definitely it leads to increase in the bill value of the retailer. The next element that we need to consider for store layout is the category flow. Now, you must have heard about a term called category adjacency. Now, what does it mean? Now, category adjacency are the categories of products which go very well together. Say, for example, if you're talking about breakfast cereals, then there is a high likelihood that breakfast cereals and tea, coffee, sugar, milk powder, these are the categories which will go very well together. So if the retailer places breakfast cereals next to tea, coffee, milk powder, milk shakes, milk mixes, that category, then there is a higher likelihood that the customers will find these two categories relevant. And that is the way that they shop, and that is, if we are going to place the products like that, there is a higher likelihood that they will shop more. So categories which have good adjacency are the categories which have a greater probability of being picked up together by the customers. Now, the customer shopping behavior also decides what kind of category flow we have. For example, the impulse categories are the categories which are placed in front, and the planned categories are the categories which are placed at the end of the store. This is typically the same discussion that we have some time back, that people come with certain products in mind when they come into the store. Now, the impulse products are something which they will pick up when they see those products. So if the impulse products are placed in the front or in front of the cash counters, they're more likely to pick up those products the moment they see those products. But the planned categories or the planned products like your cereals, your flour, all these things, are very planned in nature, and you are not likely to pick it up on whims and fancies. The other very important thought that we need to put is that shoppers do not like carrying heavy products. So if it is the large packs or the large containers, it is better if they are placed towards the end of the shopping experience, so that they can just pick up those products and move out of the store. And another very interesting observation is that the shoppers move towards the left after entering the store. So it is very highly likely that if something is kept on the right hand side, very close to the entrance, the shopper will miss that in totality. Now, if you are interested in more such insights, I would seriously recommend that you read the book Why We Buy by Paco Underhill. It is one of the most insightful books when it comes to customer shopping behavior, and I would seriously recommend that you read that book. The next element that we need to talk about is the store fixtures. Now, you would have seen that there are different types of store fixtures which are available in different retail outlets. Now, some of the fixtures are tall fixtures. Many retail outlets have very tall ceilings, and the fixtures go up right up to the ceiling. Whereas there are many retail outlets where the fixtures are not more than 5-5.5 feet in height. Now, the height of the fixture determines what kind of ambience or the visibility or the feel that you want to give for the customer. If they are low fixtures, it means that you have a greater visibility of the entire store, and it gives a much more premium feel to the store. If the fixtures are very tall, then you don't have as a customer any visibility of any aisle other than the one that you are at, and it kind of gives a slightly deep discount retailer feel. So again, the height of the fixtures is going to be determined by what kind of ambience you want to provide to your customers. Then the depth of the fixtures, again, it is a question of how much stocks you want to keep for each of those products. That is what determines the depth of the fixtures. The tall ceiling retail outlets typically have additional stocks on the tops. That is what are the shelves which are available above 6 feet of height. Then one very important decision that we need to take as a retailer is the number of cash tills that you want to place in the store. Now, the number of cash tills is determined by the number of customers who are working in and the number of bills that are being generated, or the number of invoices that are being cut. Now, if you keep the number of cash tills low, it only means that at the peak hours, the queue of the customers are going to be longer, which is not something that you would want for your customers. So you need to have the adequate number of tills so that the queue is not very long and it does not result in customer dissatisfaction. The last but not the least, the last element in this discussion is with respect to the materials, the finishes, the lighting, and the music. Now, all these things are important because they accentuate the shopper experience. They accentuate or they communicate the kind of feel that you want to give to your customers. If it is a very premium outlet, then the kind of lighting, the kind of material that you have used will communicate the same to the customers. And there is a lot of study which has gone in where it has shown that lively or peppy music actually prompts the customers to shop more. That's it for today's session. If you like the presentation, please click the like button and please subscribe to our channel for more such sessions.